I'm standing outside the gates of Parkland, the most exclusive gated community on the East Coast. Within these walls lies one of the biggest success stories of the early 21st century, the rise of Eternity.
As medical procedures allow people to live longer lives by trading in their old organs for new ones, Eternity has emerged as the leader in this field. In fact, they have become so successful at extending people's lives that their biggest problem is a shortage of healthy organs.
To solve this problem, Eternity has been looking far and wide to expand their donor pool.
More and more, they are looking in communities like these, the shanty towns that have sprung up across the United States. Here, the poor have sunk into permanent joblessness and despair, giving up any hope of ever improving their lives.
It is these shanty towns where Eternity has focused their efforts.
A massive advertising campaign entices organ donors with an offer of $10 million and a home in Parkland for their surviving family.
There's a life for your family in Parkland. What are you waiting for?
Dr. Roland Parker, the founder of Eternity, who revolutionized the organ transplant business, has become a celebrity in his own right.
His image is seen 24 hours a day from giant video billboards which bombard the poor with an offer many find difficult to refuse.
I'm Dr. Roland Parker, founder and chairman of Eternity. You owe it to yourself and to your family to be a donor. Live the dream.
Yes, you too can live the dream. Let us show you.
How'd you ever do it, Dad? Parkland. Wow.
Yeah, I'm about the only one who ever got in without donating. 741D.
It's all ours.
The whole thing?
The whole thing. Your very own room, a yard in the back with grass.
You're kidding.
Come on, your mom's gonna be waiting.
Parkland. Wow.
Hey.
Dad was just showing me the new house.
Hi, Nikki. It'd be good to get him out of here. This promotion means I'm entitled to more child support, remember?
Bye, Dad.
Would all new donors please join us in the library for the orientation? That's all new donors in the library. Afterwards, there'll be a get acquainted tea.
I'm surprised to see you here, Dr. Parker.
I wanted to oversee his destination myself.
Senator Dawson is a very important client.
You shouldn't worry. This donor is a perfect match for the senator.
I'm always amazed about how far we've gone with automation. The machine never makes mistakes like the humans did in the old days.
Starting administration of anesthetic into IV.
Donor procedure ready, Dr. Parker.
Starting automated donor extraction procedure.
Is it time?
No. A few more hours, Miss Gardner.
Do you know how I'd like to spend my last few hours? Not alone.
Thank you very much, Dr. Parker.
You're welcome, Senator.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, of course, I don't have to tell you how much Dr. Parker means to all of us, right? So I want a second medical unit on standby. No, 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 he's in excellent health, as you'll see tonight. Mm-hmm. That's right. No problem. How do these rumors get out?
Dr. Parker missed a board meeting. People talk. It'll all be put to rest tonight, though, right?
I'm sorry that you won't be there tonight.
It's okay. I'll watch it on TV.
I am so happy that you've agreed to become my wife.
I can't wait. Reminds me. I'm gonna email Julie.
Okay. Oh, honey, don't bother with that one. Something's wrong with it. Use the laptop, okay?
Sure.
Specialist McKay to Leisure Suite 1. Specialist McKay to Leisure Suite 1. Donor Asia Gardner must be escorted to the operating theater for her 3:30 appointment.
Come in to the west wing. Anybody can make it?
You guys coming back into rotation. Be aware, this is Sergeant Quinn's last day in Metro. After earning $2 million in arrest credits, he's become eligible for a transfer up to Parkland as a detective. For the record, in my entire career, I've only known one other officer to manage this. Outstanding work, Jimmy. For those of you who survive your shift, there's a farewell party at the Silver Dollar, which you are expected to attend.
All right.
Drinks are on me.
Detective Quinn, it's an honor to work with you,
sir. Have you come to worship at my feet, son? Do you seek wisdom and knowledge?
Why, you know someone who can give me some? Seriously, partner, nice going. The only guy who deserves it more is me.
You're gonna make it. Looks like I got a little going away present for you.
How's that?
Wear it in good health.
The rent a vest with bad luck.
We're on my last shift. Today we take no chances.
Jimmy! Jimmy! Try and keep your head low tonight. You got orders to make it to the Silver Dollar in good shape.
Orders from who?
Me. I got plans for you.
Sector 7-5, we're reporting a possible donor escape at Metro Terminal. Code 4, immediate response requested by Eternity. Report to Specialist Russell on the scene. Repeat, immediate response.
Let's go!
Be a false alarm. No donors ever escaped before.
Not the maternity center.
What's the code 4 worth now?
$250,000. That will put me past sergeant rank.
Alive. Look, we gotta check out the specialist first. Russell.
And lose the $250,000? Forget it.
Scotty, look, we go by the book. We gotta find a specialist. You want to step back, please?
No, she's still in the terminal. She has to be. I'll find her.
Specialist Russell? Quinn, Metro.
Oh, my God.
Kira, what is it?
Specialist McKay, she's dead.
What? You listen to me. You bring Asia Gardner back in one piece. I mean, not one bruise. She's very important to us.
One of your keepers?
Specialists. We're called specialists.
Right.
Come out now!
head. Investor's jaw hurts like hell.
We have to find her.
Go, go, go!
Call it in. Officer down. We need backup.
Police!
Both just want to live a little longer. You're worth nothing to me, Dad.
I'm already dead.
Yeah, well, you donated.
Yeah, like everybody else at Richardson. You want to be a hero? Solve my murder.
It's your mess now. You clean it up.
So, Roland, they're all waiting for us.
The usual suspects?
Mm-hmm. Two senators, half the Supreme Court, an ex-president.
Democrat or Republican?
Grand old party.
For a grand old man.
Not that old.
I'm ready. Thank you.
Good evening, my friend. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Here in the company headquarters and around this wonderful, great land of ours. I wanted you all to be here tonight to share with me the heartfelt belief that the dream that eternity represents never has been stronger than it is at this moment. We face many difficulties over the years, but we overcome them all. Because eternity is an idea that would not be denied. Ladies and gentlemen, eternity is the future. Live the dream.
Senator, nice of you to come.
Happy birthday, Dr. Parker. Very glad to be here. Very glad.
Thank you.
He wouldn't be here if it weren't for you, Dr. Parker.
Well, most of us wouldn't.
Very kind.
Happy birthday, and how old are you?
Well, I have a cake all prepared that can answer that question. For he's a jolly good fellow.
For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. Which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny. Which nobody can deny.
You're doing great.
For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. For he's a jolly good fellow. Which nobody can deny.
I feel like as good as him when we're 100.
I hope so.
You did it, darling. You did it.
Excuse me, Dr. Parker. Mrs. Parker.
What can I do for you?
I just wanted to show you my gratitude.
Thank you. You've come a long way, young man. And I'm proud of you, as you will be my own son.
Thank you. Excuse me. York. Yes. One second. One moment, please. Go ahead. Okay. All right. Asia Gardner is dead.
Oh, my God, no.
Leave this to me.
Yes, you too can live the dream. Let us show you what you're new neighborhood looks like, who your new neighbors are. There's a life for your family in Parkland. What are you waiting for? We're just a phone call away.
Everything's going to be all right. Well?
Nothing was salvaged.
How could they let it happen? Didn't they know how important she was to us?
What do we do now, Beal? How's it going to look when the founding fathers of eternity expires because he lost his donor?
Roland, we'll find another donor.
It's going to be difficult. Major Gardner was a very lucky find.
You'll find a donor, York. You know how much we're all counting on you.
I think I may have found an answer. This is a surveillance video of the incident from station security.
Who is the sergeant?
His name is Quinn. Specialist Russell thought the situation warranted police notification. I agreed.
What is she saying to him?
We'll need an audio assessment, but one thing that does leak through is Richardson.
What do we know about this sergeant?
I'll come to that.
I assume you have a purpose in showing us this.
Sergeant Quinn was wearing his microchip ID. It's standard Metro Police issue.
And?
And the security cameras read it. I believe that Mr. Quinn will be of great help to us, Dr. Parker. He's a near match to you, sir.
Yes. Good.
Just up the road.
People who take that road don't come back here.
Sergeant Quinn, congratulations. Craig Morrell, Europe 541, that work?
I was wondering if you could tell me about the incident today, about the death of the donor, Asia Gardner. I'm a reporter, Sergeant. I'm just interested in what happened. You know, just doing my job.
It was a donor, end of story.
I do have a discretionary fund. There would be the usual information fee, of course.
Look, we're having a going away party. Why don't you go away?
I'm just after the truth, Sergeant.
He said there is no story.
You change your mind.
Captain DeSalvo. Cap, how you doing? Thanks. Sit you a drink, huh? What's up?
I just came from the commissioner. She's in an uproar about this donut.
She's blaming me?
I went to the wall, Jimmy. I want you to know that.
But?
The Eternity people, they want blood. And I guess they get what they want.
What, no Parkland?
No Parkland. They're docking you 500,000 credits from your arrest record. 150,000 from Scotty just for being here. Send you around a bend.
You blew it today. And I'm paying the price.
I wasn't alone, partner.
Yeah, but you had her.
Wait! Full of tequila. I'm liking my bloodstream.
We can fight this, Jimmy. We can take it straight to the mayor.
Live the dream.
Jimmy!
The Eternity people, they want blood. And I guess they get what they want. They're docking you 500,000 credits from your arrest record, 150,000 from Scotty just for being there. It's garbage. It's wrong.
Dr. Parker, my sense of irony is not that well developed.
Live the dream.
To hell with you! To hell with all of you.
Parkland. Wow.
I could. Because you don't have a dream.
Kid's gonna have a dream.
Hi, I'm not home. Leave a message after you.
Nick's dad, where are you? We're still going out, right? Come.
I hope you're a woman. You. What are you doing here?
You came by last night, remember?
To your place?
Eternity Center.
To find you?
No, you had business.
What kind of business?
This kind.
What is this, some kind of joke?
You donated.
No, no.
Mr. Quinn, it is specified by the articles of donorship that you are to receive $10 million to spend as you see fit within a period of 30 days.
Sounds good.
You may choose not to spend it and to bequeath it to a designated beneficiary. You may not travel outside of the United States or be out of contact with your specialist. Are you clear on the terms?
Yes.
I don't believe it.
Last night you were really excited about it.
Last night I was drinking and in a fight. That's all I remember. I don't even know how I even got here.
After you were processed, I was assigned to you. I brought you home.
This is weird.
We had a long conversation about it in the car. You couldn't wait to tell your son. You don't remember?
I'm not the type to commit suicide.
Donation isn't suicide.
What is it?
We call it planned mortality with immediate benefits. It's quite a different thing.
No. You feed on people.
Donation is voluntary, Sergeant. This is all about choice. And every termination gives extended life to others.
Rich and powerful others.
Well, we're expanding our patient base all the time. And there are numerous nonprofit agencies aligned with us. They help provide transplant benefits for the underprivileged. Not to mention what we've done for law enforcement.
I'm out of here.
If you don't cooperate, you'll spend your 30 days in a leisure suite.
I'll mark my calendar. I wanted you to hear it from me. I promise you I'm gonna get through this.
Why didn't you call us? Nick doesn't care about Parkland.
I don't want you to tell him. I don't think I did this.
Jimmy, what are you saying? This is donating. There are no mistakes.
Look, I was mad. I was drunk.
Finally caught up with you?
How many times have I seen you blacked out drunk with no idea where you've been, what you've done?
I didn't do that.
Okay? They showed you the tape. You said so yourself.
I've seen Dr. Tape.
The process is flawless, and you know it. Every level of government is in there.
I gotta go. I gotta go, buddy, huh?
You coming back?
Yeah, of course I'm coming back. You know, they got me on a special case. I love you, buddy.
Jimmy? You tell him I can't.
He doesn't need to know yet. I'm his father and his future, either way.
I want to make sure nothing happens to this donor.
Kira is the best.
Yes, but she doesn't know the circumstances surrounding this donor.
No. As far as she's concerned, Quinn is just another donor. Her task is complete in 30 days.
Yes, but we may not have enough time. We have to proceed now. He's very ill.
I can tell that last night took a lot out of him, yes.
He's in a lot of pain. He doesn't show you. He doesn't show the public. He doesn't even show me. But it's getting out of hand.
One violation, and I'll bring him right in. We can't afford to lose the doctor, can we?
I'm counting on you, York.
I owe him everything. So does everybody else. I will do anything for him.
He knows that, and we both appreciate it. And if there ever comes a time where he has to step down, then you know you have my support.
You donated. How'd you know?
They called DeSalvo when you did. You're not a cop anymore, Jimmy. You're a donor.
But Scotty, you know me. Would I?
So what's up your sleeve?
Sorry, man.
I feel for you. Hell, I got screwed too, but nothing's worth what you just did.
Dreading this moment.
Yeah, well, drunk or sober, there's never been a moment in my life I thought about donating.
Obviously, there was one. You're off the job, Jimmy. You might as well enjoy yourself. Yesterday, you were only the second officer to ever put together 2 million in arrest credits. Today, you're the first one to donate. Give me the keys to your bike. Don't break the rules, Jimmy. Don't make trouble. You brought this on yourself. You learned to live with it.
You got five?
Now's not a good time, Jimmy.
Now's all the time I got.
I don't want to see it.
Look, you said you'd help me fight this.
What do you want?
Information.
You're not official anymore. First you cost Scotty. Jimmy! Okay. What do you need? Gardner, Asia. Serving 90 days at Richardson Detention Center when she applied for donation.
She mentioned Richardson to me.
Busted for trespassing.
She was sent to Richardson for trespassing?
Yeah, weird. First offense and she got the book tossed at her.
Who was the judge?
Tucker. Mean anything? Address, 652 Regan Boulevard, Old Town, no family.
What about our designated beneficiary?
The Roland Parker Fund. It's an eternity agency, donors for kids.
Why would she donate her money to the people she's trying to escape from? That doesn't make sense.
Maybe she changed her mind. People do that. Jimmy. Do me a favor. Don't fight this. Get out if you can. Go see Leo Savard. He gets people out.
I'm not running from this.
At least give yourself a chance. Talk to him, Jimmy.
Yeah.
For me.
Hey. Thanks, okay?
Want to talk to me?
I'm looking to make it to Canada.
Oh, it's a nice country. Front on this whole donation thing. No extradition treaty. Has that figured all into these recent travel plans?
Oh, buddy, I'm on the chopping block. Literally. So spare me.
Just an observation. Law and order can go out the window when it doesn't serve you.
What are you talking about? You talking about me?
Everybody. Leo's talking about everybody. So I hear you say you didn't donate.
Don't remember it.
Don't matter.
It's a scam I wanted uncovered.
It's over. You donated it. Don't make it worse.
How could it possibly get any worse?
You go asking the wrong questions, looking into the wrong rocks, you'll be dead a lot sooner than 30 days.
What do you know?
I know I can get you to Canada. Think about it, then call me.
Darling, I'll be right back. What'd you find out?
I've done all I can. We might have to wait the 30 days. It was incredibly lucky to find this match.
We don't have 30 days.
We have procedures. We can't...
Procedures? You don't seem to understand. My husband is dying.
I know that he's dying.
Look, whatever you need, the police, whatever level of government, it's yours. Just get this done now.
Thank you. Kira.
The situation could be changing. We might have to foreclose on the sergeant a little early.
But why?
He's been rated priority one.
What? I don't understand.
Well, I can't say more than that.
He has 30 days. It's the law.
Not if he breaks his contract and attempts flight. Has he shown any signs?
No, none. He's been very cooperative.
I see.
York, he's a donor. He has rights.
Kira, I put you on this case because I trusted you.
We have a lot at stake here. I thought you understood that.
I gotta go.
I'll call you later.
The missing.
It's propaganda. It's dangerous nonsense.
How'd you find me?
You have a locator chip.
I'm impressed.
It won't hurt you. It's just a pacifier. You'll be all right. Just relax.
Get this off.
No, not yet. Look, I'm here to help you.
Protest.
Protest?
Donor. Home. Asia.
What?
Asia
Gardner?
Gardner. Help me.
If I take this off, you have to promise me you're not gonna run.
Help. Look, I'm not gonna run, but you better keep up.
All right, I'm here. I'm listening. That's what I've been trained for.
Great. Look, it just doesn't add up, okay? She was a protester. She doesn't fit the donor profile.
Well, $10 million can change a person's mind.
She believed she'd been murdered.
It was suicide. We were both there.
I saw it in her eyes, okay? She believed she'd been murdered. She felt she was set up. I'm starting to feel the same thing. Why am I even telling you this? You're one of them.
Yeah, I am. And I'm proud of the work we've accomplished. Both my parents are alive because of our programs. Parkland is all I've ever known, and it's been good to me. And now those same opportunities will be available for your son. Isn't that why you donated?
Look, I didn't donate, okay? I didn't donate. Can you get me some names? Can I get her donor list, maybe?
It's unethical.
Her life and death was very important to those people.
Where'd you meet?
At work.
Love at first sight, huh?
Is that really any of your business?
Well, you know every sort of detail of my life.
York is a wonderful man. He's strong, reliable, intelligent. Perfect for me.
Now say it like you believe it.
Why am I even discussing this with you?
Hey, I was just, you know.
Yeah, I know.
Look, it's been a long day for both of us. Why don't you take the bed?
No, I'll take the couch. You take the bed.
Hey, buddy. How you doing? I'm sorry I didn't call.
No, buddy. Listen, I'm good.
Listen, I break this case, so I make that promotion look like nothing. Just gotta give me a couple days, huh? Hey, I love you, huh? Okay. See you tomorrow.
Left the harvest.
What do you want?
Guess. Turn around.
Well, let him go and we cleaned them out. That's what you want, right? He spends his premium, he's yours.
We're doing you a favor.
$10 million. He doesn't want to hurt you. Quit in here.
Barcode scan and transfer. Leo sends his regards.
He's all yours, Scotty.
Hey,
Jimmy.
Scotty, what are you doing here?
Been thinking about the $250,000 you let slip through our fingers yesterday. Other people have been thinking about it too.
Scotty, time out. What's going on?
Parkland upped the donor escape fee to $500,000.
Rules are changing, huh? This is a setup.
Quinn, it's not about you. It's a lot bigger than you.
Quinn,
let's go.
Worked out very well for us, especially for you. An attempted escape foiled by his own ex-partner, the police force demonstrating loyalty to Eternity, and you avoid a donor escape on your record.
Did we send those men, York?
I'll ignore that. Maybe you should concentrate on the upside of this. We have the good sergeant right where we want him, and not a moment too soon. Dr. Parker is fading fast.
Dr. Parker?
That's right, I can tell you now. Sergeant Quinn is taking the place of the Gardner woman as his donor.
What? Dr. Parker's a rare tissue and blood type, isn't he?
Well, he's not a perfect match, but he's close enough, thank God. The doctors feel it's worth the risk.
Is that why his term was shortened?
His term was shortened because of his infraction. The sergeant's bad luck is our good luck. Nothing more, Kira.
York, how long have you known that Sergeant Quinn was a donor match?
What kind of a question is that?
He claims he was set up. Was he?
He volunteered, like every other donor. Kira, there is no way to set someone up. It's a tired myth.
I saw the tape.
And it speaks for itself. Yes? Yes, Mrs. Parker.
Mm-hmm.
That's right, it's very good news. Yes, he's at Richardson Jail. No, that won't be a problem. Specialist Russell will be bringing him in. Fine.
Quinn!
Your visitor's here.
How you doing?
I've been better. Thanks for coming.
I gotta tell you, I wasn't surprised to get your call.
You know why I'm in here, don't you?
I got some hunches.
I'll share them.
You just don't get it, do you? Asia Gardner and you were both...
set up.
Yeah.
What about Judge Tucker? What does he have to do with this?
Judge Tucker? It's good, but... oh, he did his part, but... he wasn't alone.
I don't have a lot of time for this. What do you know?
I know the walls have ears. Look, I'll help you.
Yeah. You're gonna help me.
But don't worry about it. You just remember I want something in return. Something big.
What, my liver?
That's funny. You keep your sense of humor, you're gonna need it.
Visit's over.
Now, I want your story.
Okay, Quinn, they want you.
Who?
Hand out. I'm putting this on you one way or the other.
Following us in a set. You gotta ditch this truck, get that thing off your wrist.
You just bought yourself a pack of trouble. You want the story that bad?
Yeah. My little brother went missing. I don't know why.
Wayne, you got security cameras in here?
Nah, don't need them.
You wouldn't be lying to me.
This is a cop bar. Why do I need cameras?
I want to know what happened in here.
I know we have surveillance cameras.
So, this is the scene of the crime, huh? Cute.
Hey, there's a lot of dirty cops out there, you know? A guy's got to make a living.
Set it up. Rewind it.
Time's up.
I got proof now. You want to see the tape?
What I saw was a drunk in a bar fight. It's inconclusive.
There was somebody else there.
So someone was watching the fight. Hey, don't.
Can I just talk to you? Please? I'm not giving up without a fight. If you want this body in one piece.
What do you want?
I need to get into the Eternity Center. Quietly.
You crazy?
No. Just innocent. I need to get to the donor files.
We don't think all your donations have been voluntary.
If I don't find anything, I'll give up freely. Body parts intact.
What, you're afraid we are gonna find something?
You're not gonna find anything.
And you have nothing to lose.
I want to trust you.
You can.
One false move. Look, if this is true, I want to give your son the chance to keep his father.
Fair enough.
I'll set up a mobile unit outside Eternity. You find something, you feed it directly to me, I'll do the rest.
Yeah.
The one they're waiting for?
It's James Quinn.
Barcode, please. Leisure Suite 12, but he shouldn't get too comfortable. They're about ready for him.
Okay, thanks. By the way, is York Beale here yet?
No, he's out with Mrs. Parker, but they're expected back soon.
Thanks, Padilla.
You're welcome.
Yeah, Larry, Morrell, listen, there may be something big going down this afternoon. I want you to have a full crew standing by ready to preempt. No, believe me, if we get this story, nobody's gonna complain about expense, okay? So just get us an uplink channel and keep it open, no matter what anybody says. I want full coverage, coast to coast, live feed. Believe me, it's that big. No, it's okay. I've got cameras directly patched into the van's uplink. I can do intro, commentary. I just need tech standing by so they can cut in immediately on my go. No, immediately, Larry. Have I ever let you down before?
Any cameras?
No, your place is privacy. These are the donation files.
A lot of body parts. Let's go to the queues, huh?
Quaid, Quarles, Quincy. Randolph. No Quinn.
It's gotta be here somewhere. Check in there.
To keep the link open.
case we go to air.
Okay, come on, Jimmy. Come on, Jimmy.
Does he have a safe?
No, not that I know of.
Can you hack into this?
It's broken. The other day he said, it's not like him to leave loose ends. Recorded when you had your microchip, it would record your data.
That's how Beale got my information.
Yeah. 0345, Thursday, April 21st, 2013. Subject is Quinn James, Sergeant, Metro Division Police. Recruited by Chief Executive York Beale. Received in a state of post-trauma sedation. Ready for UD-101 application.
Oh my God, York.
Your fiancé? UD-101. Looks like the magic bullet, huh?
Sergeant Quinn, you are here of your own volition because you want to be here. Are you clear?
Yes.
You are waking up. You'll become fully alert and you will be yourself in every way. You are in the Eternity Donation Center. Are you clear?
Yes.
You are here to donate yourself for a fee of $10 million, according to the Articles of Donorship. Now.
You have not been coerced. You're not afraid.
And?
You have no doubts that you want to be a donor.
Are you clear?
Yes.
You have no imagination, Beale. Sometimes I wonder. Mrs. Parker.
The Mrs. Parker. Charming.
Now, Sergeant, you've been a bit under the weather lately. Quite sick, really. You're dying of a neural edema. And we here at Eternity feel your pain. And we want to make you comfortable. You only have days left. And we want to make them comfortable. And make sure that the family that you left behind want for nothing. You're very grateful, Sergeant.
Yes.
When you become fully alert, you will remember nothing of what has transpired here. Are you clear?
Yes.
Now.
What are we waiting for?
Nothing, Sergeant Quinn. This is Mr. Robertson and Judge Tucker from the State's Contracts Commission. They're here as witnesses.
Glad we're doing this. My family gets to keep any money I don't spend, right?
Absolutely.
I knew I was innocent.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Look, we have to get this to Morrell. You hack in here?
It's locked. I need his password.
Okay, try.
What?
Still waiting for transmission. Nothing coming through.
Room is ready?
It is.
I want you to bring down a police escort for this.
We have our own security.
Yes, I know. Commissioner McIntosh, it's Elizabeth Parker. Thank you, yes. I'd appreciate if you could send up a detail to make sure there are no more incidents. Thank you. They're on their way. Mrs. Parker.
Has the sergeant arrived?
Leisure Suite 12, sir. Specialist Russell is preparing him for his donation.
Ah, Specialist Russell. I'm gonna get my husband. Bring the sergeant upstairs.
Yes, ma'am.
Beale, I want you to check on Quinn personally.
Attention, this is York Beale. We are initiating a shutdown of the facility. Would all donors and their guests please return to your leisure suites immediately?
immediately. Put on
non-security staff. Please return to your offices for the time being. Thank you.
We've got to get out of here. Jimmy!
Security, my office.
He escaped from his leisure suite. I tracked him here.
How the hell do you get free?
I don't know. He's a cop. I guess he figured out how to disarm the pacifier. Hey, I wouldn't try anything. It's all over now.
I guess this means I can't collect on you twice.
Take this man to the donation room right now.
I'll go along, make sure everything goes smoothly.
You know, you're a very special donor. Your organs are going to Dr. Parker himself. Think of that.
Eternity is the future.
Don't worry, darling. You'll be as good as new in half an hour. I'll be in my office. Call me when he's done.
Yes, Mrs. Parker.
I love you, Elizabeth.
I've been getting the nation over 50 years. Enjoy yours the most.
Drop the gun. Drop it. Kick it away.
Looking for this? You risked all of this. All of this for Quinn.
Does this mean you want your engagement ring back?
Position.
I should thank you, York.
Thank me?
Yeah. I almost married a bastard.
You've obviously seen the disc.
Yeah. Is that what you did to Asia Gardner, too?
We saved your father's life. Remember? And we gave you a lifestyle that most people would kill for. Who do you think made that happen?
Yeah, but at whose expense, York?
Stop.
You'd shoot someone you love?
Don't try me.
Drop it. I said drop it.
didn't have much of a choice.
How about you?
I'm all right. Get the password from him. We need to send the proof to Morell.
You heard her. What's the password? What is it?
Up yours.
What is it?
Kira.
What?
Kira's the best.
Kira! Kira's the password!
You did it, guys. You did it.
This is for my husband.
We interrupt our regular programming to bring you a special report on Parkland. You've been a bit under the weather lately. Quite sick, really.
You're dying of a neural edema. And we here at Eternity feel your pain.
Oh my God, no!
Shoot him! Shoot him!
Police went through Eternity's files and discovered that only 20% of the donations were truly voluntary. 80% were coerced. Eternity's success was built on mass murder. As for Jimmy Quinn, he was completely vindicated. Near death one minute, he was a hero the next. He was welcomed back on the police force with a promotion. He was also given back his job at Parkland. But he turned it down.